We will discuss two forms which are used for the simplification of a logical function. These are the sum of products form or SOP, and the second one is the product of sums form or POS. So two forms are used for the simplification of any logical function. These are the sum of products form and the product of sums form. In today's lecture, we will discuss the first form, that is the sum of products or the SOP form. For this, let us take an example. Example 1 shows a logical function of 4 variables f, a, b, c, d. Its value is equal to a complement plus bc into b plus cd. We have to express this function as sum of products. So if we want to express the function f a b c d as sum of products, then first we will make use of the distributive law. So using the distributive law, we can write this expression as a complement plus bc multiplied with b plus a complement plus bc multiplied with cd. Now when we simplify this expression, it comes out to be a complement b plus b bc plus a complement cd plus b c cd. Now we find here that the variable b has been repeated twice, so we can eliminate one of the variables because the value of b into b is equal to b. Similarly, here the variable c has been repeated twice, so we will eliminate one of the variables because c into c is c. So our expression comes out to be f a b c d is equal to a complement b plus b c plus a complement c d plus b c d. Here we find that in this expression, the individual terms are the products of the variables. The individual terms are the products of the variables. And we are taking the sum of all these terms. Here we find that this is the individual term is the product of a complement and b. Second term is the product of variable b and variable c. Third term is the product of a complement c and d. And the fourth term is the product of b, c and d. And we are taking the sum of all these products. This is the product which has been denoted by p. So these are the products. And we are taking the sum which has been denoted by s. So we find that in this expression, the individual terms are the products of the variables, and we are taking the sum of all these terms. That is why this form is called the sum of products form or the SOP. Let us take another example. Here we find that in example 2, we are given a logical function of 5 variables, that is f, a, b, c, d, e. This is a function of 5 variables, and its value is equal to a plus bc complement multiplied by d plus be whole complement. Now we have to express this function as the sum of products. Here we find that we have the complement terms also involved here over a number of variables. So in this case, in order to simplify this logical function in the sum of products form, we will have to make use of De Morgan's theorem as well as distributive law. So using the De Morgan's theorem and the distributive law, we find that this can be written as, first we will have to apply De Morgan's theorem. So this, according to the De Morgan's first theorem, we can write this as B complement plus C complement. Similarly, this from De Morgan's second theorem, we can write this as D complement multiplied by B complement. Again, B whole complement from the De Morgan's first theorem can be written as B complement plus E complement. And after this, we will make use of the distributive law. So if we make use of the distributive law, then we get this term can be written as A plus B complement plus C complement. And here we have just simplified these terms, so it comes out to be B complement into D complement plus D complement into E complement.
Now from distributive law, this can be written as A into B bar into D plus A into D bar into E bar plus B bar into D, D bar. Now because the variable B bar is repeated twice, so one term gets cancelled and so the term comes out to be B complement into D complement. Then again we get the term B complement, D complement, E complement plus B complement, C complement, D complement plus C complement, D complement, E complement. Again we find here that the individual terms, this is the individual term, this is the product of the variables C complement, D complement and E complement. Similarly, this term is the product of the variables B complement, C complement and D complement. This term is the product of the variables B complement, D complement and E complement. This term is the product of variables B complement and D complement. This term is the product of variables A, D complement and E complement. And similarly, this term is the product of the variables A, B complement and D complement. So the individual terms are the product of the variables and we are taking the sum of all these terms. That is why this form is called the sum of products form. So from example 1 and 2, we find that how we can express any arbitrary logical expression in the sum of products form. And in doing so, we should keep in mind that the same variable need not appear twice in the product, and if it is repeated, then we will just eliminate one of the variables by making use of the theorem A dot A is equal to A. And if we have any term in which the variable is multiplied by its complement, then we will substitute the that value is equal to 0. Now in example 1 and example 2, we find that the individual terms does not involve all the 5 variables. The individual term does not involve all the 5 variables. So this is not the standard sum of products form. So in the next lecture, we will discuss how we can write a given logical expression in the standard sum of product forms. Hope the sum of product form is clear to all of you. So in the next lecture, we will discuss the standard sum of products form.